Do you want to make some Christmas cards, but are you worried that you can't come up with fun new ideas? If you think about Christmas, you probably think about red and green, Christmas trees and snow. And I don't know about you, but I hate the combination of red and green together and I never use it in my work. Today I'm going to attempt to make some Christmas cards that convey the cozy feeling of winter. I'll talk about what I'm thinking while designing, and hopefully it will be helpful to you when you're making your own Christmas card designs. Grab something to drink, grab your sketchbook, and remember to have fun! I'm going to be doing everything in a square sketchbook. I want to make some square cards, and my sketchbook is my safe place. I feel like if I get some fancy paper, I will stress too much about it and overcomplicate things. Also, if my design fails, I won't have the feeling of just having ruined an expensive piece of paper. I can just flip to the next page and try again. So, sketchbook it is. After I'm done, I will just scan in the finished page and edit it so it looks right. If you want to make your own Christmas cards directly on a card that you are going to send out, you can do that, of course. Since I'm going to send them off to print and sell, this works way better for me. It allows me to work on a bigger scale too, so I can put some more detail into the card. And you guys know that I'm a huge fan of keeping my work together in the sketchbook, so this works best for me. Most of the time I sketch a bit first. Some days I have many ideas and I can start on a piece right away. It's probably not the best way to make a design, but if you have trouble getting going, then this might be a good way, because you can jump right into the fun stuff. Today I don't have any good ideas clearly in my mind. I have some fake ideas, so I'm going to explore those. I have been thinking about making Christmas cards, and I have been looking at different card designs that other people have made to gather some ideas before I went into my sketchbook. So, over the last few days, I did think about a few different ideas. I want to sketch a few of them out before I pick one to work on. Sketching also helps me to warm up, because in the beginning of an art session, my lines are sometimes really stiff, and you don't want those in your big piece that you are going to work for hours on. Also, since I know I want to make some more Christmas cards, I try to keep my sketchbook close to me, so that whenever I have an idea, I can make a quick thumbnail sketch to work out later. Once I have an idea that looks fun to do, I'll start sketching. I don't have a way set in stone of how I make my pieces, I just do whatever feels right at the moment, and I try out many different things. Lately, I've been really liking this layering technique where you put down a light wash of color on the entire piece first. This makes it really easy to get colors that work well together, especially if you work in watery layers when you're using gouache. Since I'm using a blue wash here, it gives the whole piece a wintry vibe. Then it's time to put layers on top, building until you are happy with the paints. I try to keep my colors very similar here, and I don't want to use too much red because I have so many green elements, and as I said before, I don't like the combination of red and green together. By the way, I worked on this piece over a few sessions. Since this paper doesn't dry very fast, I take longer breaks in between. I also sketched out another idea for a Christmas card on the page next to the piece I'm currently working on. Something I often do is when I have layers that need to dry, but I do want to continue working, is to have another piece I also need to work on ready. So that's what I'll do here. You see me switching in between the two pieces quite often. The second piece is a little bit simpler because the first one was so much work that I wanted also a few designs that would go a little bit faster. In most of these Christmas cards, I want to focus on human connection and love, since I think that's the best thing about Christmas season. I can paint as many snowy Christmas trees as I want, but I think it works best when my cards have an emotion that people can relate to. So I make cards where my characters spend time together and care for each other, as that is something that I can relate to myself. While my base layer for the second postcard is drying, I work on the first postcard again. When I was done with all the paints, I also went in with some colored pencil. I really like colored line work, but I haven't found a color pencil brand that I really like for them yet. I use the Carandache Pablo pencils in this piece, but I'm not sure if I like the line quality they produced. I wasn't sure what to do, so I just decided to try out some different things and see if they would work out. I added this simple pattern to the background and used a black liner for the faces of my characters. I'm actually not sure if I'm in love with how this looks, and I don't know if I really like how this Christmas card designer turned out. Maybe I'll post it on Instagram to see if people are interested or not, or I'll just paint some more Christmas cards until I have a few that I like. Sometimes you set out to create something for a specific purpose and it doesn't turn out how you want it to. That's okay, I don't need to order this design as a print if I'm not feeling it. Most of the time when I make a few different ones, there will be one or two that I like enough to order. If I end up ordering cards that I don't really like, I will definitely regret it later. If I look back at what I've ordered in the past, I know that the ones that I liked a few years ago, I probably still like them now. But if I was unsure about it back then, I regret buying them and now I am stuck with hundreds of postcards that I don't like. So maybe it's not perfect for a Christmas card, but I actually do really like this drawing. I just don't know if I want to order it as a card. Maybe I'll end up making a sticker instead. That's enough about what I'm going to do with this piece. Let's talk a little bit more about the other side of this spread. I was struggling a lot with the colors and I didn't know what I wanted to do with the line art. I also added this dirty looking ground they are standing on and I don't know if that was a good choice. I actually liked it more when it was just pencil. But I do try to experiment in my sketchbook and sometimes it doesn't work out. I don't want to get stuck into doing the same thing over and over again because that's the only thing I know. Experimenting may lead to some more failures. But it also leads to many new ways to draw things. So I didn't like the pencil art I did on the other page, but I also didn't want to use just a black fine liner. So instead I used this gray water-based fine liner on this page. I hoped it would blend a little bit with the gouache underneath and give it a soft look to the line art. I'm not sure if I managed that effect, but I do think it looks pretty good. Maybe I'll play around with some more colored fineliners in the future. Now this piece is finished, and again, it's not a piece I'm perfectly happy with. I do feel like I learned a lot from making these, and I will just continue working on some more ideas. Even though they didn't really work out for me, I hope it was still in some way helpful for you. Even if it was just a small push of motivation to work on your own card designs. If you like this video, be sure to let me know in some way or another. You could do it, for example, by leaving a like, leaving a comment, or subscribing to my channel. I'm on a good YouTube streak, so I'm going to try and upload another video next week on Friday. I hope to see you back then. Bye bye!